So hello, Zoa. Welcome to IWM Buzz. This is your host, Shubhajit Ghosh. Thank you so much for joining me over here. First of all, before we talk about your projects or anything else, whatever you have been doing so far or whatever you will be doing, you battle something which is absolutely, at this point of time, very critical in terms of, this given situation. And one thing is actually battling and coming out, and the other thing is actually going forward and looking to help others. Now, you have donated plasma not once but twice, and that's, I think, a remarkable thing to do. But I want to know something, ki jis time pe aapko ye hua tha, at that point of time, the awareness probably was not as much as what it is right now. And also, it was very intense at that point of time. We were talking about the third wave and everything. So when you actually got it, now, what was the first thought that actually came in your mind? And did you have any negative thoughts? Because obviously, it's not the ideal situation you want to be. So how did you actually battle yourself? To come out of it is one thing, but then when you get it, how do you handle yourself?
So I feel like for some reason, everything in my life that happens is very dramatic, like either good or bad. But if it's good, it's good. And if it's bad, it's bad. So I don't know. I think when the virus happened, it was very hard to accept because I used to very rarely fall ill. The cold and cough and all, like, thankfully, I never really fall ill very often. And then suddenly, really not feeling good. And I was like, what is this? It just doesn't feel normal. It's not feeling like a normal cough and cold. And at home also, if I would say, oh my God, what if I've got the virus? Everybody would be like, oh, don't talk rubbish. And, it's just out in the news. So, aise lagta hai ki, you're just like imagining it. So, I think that initial part was very tough because, I mean, you're also scared, right? Because, you're feeling all the things you're reading, but then you want to be like, oh my God, do I actually, that has caused this entire. I think it was very weird and very hard, but I feel like, when you go through something, you kind of get the inner strength for the moment to deal with it. That's what happened with me. From I don't know where, I just like, I feel like I was getting the strength. And also, in the past couple of years, I've developed these very helpful techniques, you can say, to help me deal with my emotions. Like, I used to be an extra, you could say I was very aggressive. I was too emotional. Basically, not knowing how to handle myself, like back in the day. But then over the years, I tried to learn, with yoga practice and with chanting and all these things. I kind of got a control over myself. And I felt that really helped me, even during the virus part.
Well, you started on that note. Obviously, 2020 wasn't the best of starts for anyone. But, you're ending it pretty much on a high, with good projects coming in. There's a good lineup that's there. Taish happened and, Bijoy Nambiar, these are big directors, people who want to work with all the time. These are those, to-do list wale people whom we usually tend to have in our list. Inke saath to kaam karna hai. Now, I want to ask you something, ki at this stage of your career, the place where you are positioned at the moment, and only you can understand where you are positioned best because nobody else can do it for you. Given your position at this point of time, how do you actually prioritize, the content or, the production? What is actually the main priority? Is it the director that you want to get associated with, which you feel will be a lot helpful for your career? Or is it always the script in the first place? And you might say no to a probably lesser known director with a better script. What is it like? Because it's a very interesting stage. You are growing and growing and growing. So it's very important to take calculated steps so that, no measure goes wrong. So what do you actually do? And what is your mantra regarding handling all these, calculations and miscalculations?
So, I feel like with Bijoy, it was the first time that I got to work with a director that comes with experience. For some reason, I worked with before this was a debutant director. So, I just feel like that that makes such a difference. I mean, obviously, I'm completely so grateful to all the other directors that have given me work. But I just feel like I'm really craving to grow. I'm really craving my director to sit with me and like remove things out of me or like get these layers into my character. So I feel like I'm really work with good directors. I feel like that's what I need right now. Good characters. Yes. And I think out of my experience, I don't know, it could be different for others. I feel like on script, I've always really got good scripts. Like on paper, But you know, something or the other sometimes would go wrong in the transformation of the script to the screen.
Correct.
So, yes, of course, for me, the story is everything. And especially in these times where content is king. Nobody really cares about anything.
Yes, exactly.
You're so exposed to such good content. So, of course, content has to be number one. But answering your question, I feel like what I'm craving for maximum is to work with good, experienced directors. Like that is...
And I think you mentioned a very important point right here where, you know, probably the script is really strong, as hard and rock solid. But then, you know, when it comes to translating it, it's nobody's fault. It just doesn't go the way it should have been. But on the other hand, sometimes a weaker script is actually translated in a beautiful fashion by an experienced director. So I think that's a very valid point that you mentioned. Now, you're talking about experienced directors. You know, Bijoy Nambiar-san has been, you know, ticked. Next is Sanjay Leela Bhansali. He is another biggie in almost everybody's list. And, you know, these are things, this is just the starting of some really lovely things going forward. I hope the same. But, you know, ye jo stage abhi aa gaya, now that you, so initially chance, you know, time hota when you're not in a position to choose. But now, dheere dheere, you're getting into that position where you can choose. So how much do you think smart decisions actually play a role? Because, you know, you might be getting offers from a lot of good directors, but still, you know, you got to pick and choose and prioritize. I want to give my dates to this project, or I don't want to, you know, invest my time on this. So how do you actually balance, you know, the art of saying no? Because, I mean, given the position you're in, you will obviously be saying yes, but you also need to say no to a lot of things.
No, I wish I was in the position that you're talking about.
Yeah.
I don't think I've reached there yet, honestly speaking. I don't know how to answer this question because I truly don't believe that I have reached that spot yet. I still am in that phase where I, luckily, no, of course, to a certain extent, yes. Like, I feel like I'm spoiled now after working with Bijoy. Suddenly, I feel like that little scary, you know, I'm questioning my, that, oh my God, are you behaving spoiled? And you better come back to the ground. But that's what happens, I guess, right? Because when you go out there and you see the growth and you see what directors can actually do with you, then automatically you also want that more. So I just hope to, inshallah, be in that position sometimes. Yeah. But I'm not yet.
Well, as you said, you are partially definitely there. You will be reaching obviously greater heights. But, you know, ek cheez main aapko batana chahunga ki you obviously started, I think you worked with Farah ma'am as well in the assistant direction team for Om Shanti Om. So that's a great learning in itself. I want to know ki how much actually does, you know, becoming a part of the production stage before actually getting into acting help as an actor? Because one thing is knowing about acting and the other thing is, you know, probably, you know, working in the movie set. I mean, both are two different things.
Yeah, no, in fact, I feel if you were to ask me, I feel what I learned acting-wise in my workshops and through my directors, I feel it was far more than what I probably must have learned on vice being of assistant director to Farah ma'am. Because I feel like acting, you have to do it, right? So, yes, it was a very big movie and it was such an amazing experience just seeing that whole movie come to life. But I feel like if I had used that time to work on my skill, to try and understand what all do we need as an actor, what tools we need as an actor, I feel it would help me much more. Like if someone were to come and ask me that today I have this choice, I have a choice either to become an assistant director or to join an acting school, what should I do? I would say acting school.
Prefer the acting school part.
Yeah, because you're doing it on the floor there, you know. Here you're just observing it, which is also good in a way. Yeah. But what...
Yeah.
Workshops, I feel it's
well, everything at the end of the day counts as a form of learning, so I'm pretty sure with that as well you must have definitely grown and gone forward. But you know, ek cheez with before which I cannot really end the conversation is that, you know, there are discussions about, you know, censorship coming in OTT as well, and you know, content has, you as you described, is the king or queen, whatever, that has always been the case, and with OTT that has been the foremost priority. Now, with, you know, these kind of stuff coming in, you know, discussions about, you know, censorship and OTT, do you think it's going to disturb the balance that a creative, you know, person has in terms of making a good work? Because probably something which is not good for the 70mm on, you know, screen is amazing for the OTT platform. But with censorship, do you think, you know, the liberty is kind of going to get a bit damaged? Do you think it's going to get hampered for both as an artist as well as a director?
Yes, of course. I think any, like they say, creativity is limitless, right? So any kind of restrictions is going to damage a particular creative process of a director. But having said that, I think personally, as a person, I'm very Indian at heart, and I'm very like, I feel like it's good also in a way for me.
I
am. Because I think from the like the way my heart and mind works, I feel like the Indian culture means a lot to me. So, you know, with these restrictions, maybe we will not get too influenced by the West on try and stick to what our Indian culture actually is. About it. But having because I do enjoy a lot of other Western kind of projects too. So having said that, I still think it is going to affect it. But being an Indian, I feel like I'm happy also. So I don't know.
So it's, I think, a nice balance, and you're seeing the good side of it as well. I hope everybody sees that as well. And thank you so much for talking to us. It's a pleasure. I wish you all the best. And congratulations to you once again for what you have done during that time, because abhi to chalo theek hai, it's a lot better right now. Things will get better. The awareness is a lot more. But when you go ahead and donate two plasmas, and in that situation, it's creating a trend. So thank you so much for doing whatever you have done. And I hope that you are very, you know, amazing and fine in terms of your health in the future as well. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.